The coronavirus can make people sick, usually with a mild to moderate upper respiratory tract illness, which can be similar to a common cold. Symptoms include a runny nose, cough, sore throat, possibly a headache, and maybe a fever lasting for a couple of days. But in people with a weakened immune system, especially the elderly and the very young, the virus could be more serious. In these groups, the virus could cause a lower and much more serious respiratory tract illness like pneumonia or bronchitis.
So coronaviruses typically cause respiratory symptoms, so we recommend basic hand hygiene such as washing your hands with soap and water, and respiratory hygiene such as when you sneeze, sneezing into your elbow.
The new discovery comes in the wake of the SARS or severe acute respiratory syndrome outbreak in 2003 and the first human detection of MERS-CoV or the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome coronavirus in 2012. SARS and MERS are two of the deadly human coronaviruses. The Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, also known as the MERS virus, was first reported in the Middle East in 2012 and also causes respiratory problems, but those symptoms are much more severe. It is deadly for 3 to 4 out of every 10 patients that get infected. The severe acute respiratory syndrome, also known as SARS, is the other coronavirus that can cause more severe symptoms. SARS causes respiratory problems but can also cause diarrhea, fatigue, shortness of breath, respiratory distress, and kidney failure. Depending on the patient's age, the death rate with SARS can range from 0 to 50% of the cases, with older people being the most vulnerable.
Coronaviruses are a family of viruses that range from the common cold to MERS coronavirus, which is Middle East Respiratory Syndrome coronavirus, and SARS, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus. Coronaviruses are circulating in animals, and some of these coronaviruses have the capability of transmitting between animals and humans. We call that a spillover.
With coronavirus being a zoonotic virus, it spreads from human contact with animals. Once it reaches humans, it can spread fast, as it often spreads when someone comes into contact with the infected person's secretions. Depending on how virulent the virus is, a cough, sneeze, or a handshake can cause exposure. The virus can also be transmitted by touching something an infected person has touched and then touching your mouth, nose, or eyes. Caregivers can sometimes be exposed by handling a patient's waste. There is no specific treatment for the coronavirus. Doctors can relieve symptoms by prescribing pain or fever medication, but most of the time, symptoms will go away on their own. A room humidifier or a hot shower can help with a sore throat or cough. If infected, drink plenty of fluids, get rest, and sleep as much as possible. However, if the symptoms feel worse than a common cold, it's important to see the doctor.
Ways to protect yourself against a potential animal source would be to avoid unnecessary, unprotected contact with live animals and to make sure that you wash your hands thoroughly after contact with an animal, and also to make sure that your meat is cooked thoroughly before consuming.
Avoid contact with any symptomatics. And if a person is, suppose, coming from China, and if he or she has developed this type of symptom, then they must restrict themselves if they want to prevent this infection to others. So, and immediately report to a health facility.
There is no vaccine to protect against this family of viruses, at least not yet. But you may be able to reduce your risk of infection by avoiding people who are sick.